On Monday, Commander Kevin Ford had charged the batteries in the synchronized position hold, engage, reorient experimental satellites known as spheres, and reviewed experiment procedures to prepare for a test session of a ground-commanded spheres vertigo experiment. The objective of the experiment is to demonstrate the ability to create a three-dimensional model of an object in space using the free-flying spheres robots. Also on Monday, Marshburn had performed some maintenance work on a carbon dioxide removal assembly in the Destiny Laboratory, removing and replacing a descant bed and other components. Hadfield on Monday had set up the microflow technology demonstration hardware and tested biological samples with its miniaturized flow cylinder. Hadfield also had some time set aside to participate in an in-flight educational event with students in Alberta, answering some questions about his experiment work and life aboard the space station. On Tuesday, Hadfield had worked with the voice-activated crew user interface system enhancement, also known as CRUSE, which is a European Space Agency technology demonstration that hopes to someday improve crew members' operations and work efficiency aboard the station. Marshburn had collected air samples for analysis and performed an inspection of the compound-specific analyzer combustion products, changing out the batteries in all of the units, as well as calibrating and deactivating them. Ford, Marshburn, and Hadfield also had some time set aside to participate in an in-flight interview with CNN's newsroom program. They answered questions about science and life aboard the orbiting laboratory. Expedition 34 Commander Kevin Ford handed over the command of the International Space Station to Flight Engineer Chris Hadfield during a change of command ceremony on Wednesday. Hadfield, a veteran of the Canadian Space Agency, is the first Canadian commander of the space station. Expedition 35 will officially begin with the undocking of the Soyuz TMA-06M spacecraft. On Wednesday, Ford and flight engineers Yevgeny Turokhin and Novinsky had continued their preparations for their journey back to Earth, stowing away items and making their final equipment checks. On Wednesday, Marshburn had worked with the capillary flow experiment, too. This investigates how fluids flow across surfaces in a weightless environment. Results from this experiment will improve computer models used to design fluid transfer systems and fuel tanks on the future spacecraft. Also on Wednesday, Hadfield had loaded software into the computers that govern the functions of the Window Observation Research Facility, known as WARF, in the Destiny Laboratory, and also transferred cargo into the SpaceX Dragon cargo craft. And on Thursday, the three Expedition 34 crew members wrapped up preparations for their return to Earth. After nearly 5 months aboard the International Space Station, Commander Kevin Ford of NASA, Russian Soyuz Commander Oleg Novitsky, and Russian Flight Engineer Yevgeny Turokhin were scheduled to undock their Soyuz spacecraft from the space station yesterday evening. Because of inclement weather prohibited the recovery efforts, the Russian Federal Space Agency decided Thursday late afternoon to postpone the evening's landing of Expedition 34 and its Soyuz TMA-06M spacecraft. Ford, Turokhin, and Novitsky will try again today for their homecoming, preparing for a landing northeast of the Kazakh town of Arkalyk early Saturday morning on Kazakh time. The landing is scheduled to take place at 10:05 p.m. Central Time. Today, 8 of the 12 Russian helicopters were deployed earlier this morning from Kustanai to pre-stage for the landing operations near the prime landing zone and at the leading edge of the ballistic landing zone for tonight. The other four helicopters with support personnel will deploy from Kustanai directly to the landing site early Saturday morning on Kazakh time later this evening. Forecast for landing is just about perfect, with a few clouds expected and temperatures in the mid-teens. We'll provide coverage of the Expedition 34 crew departure at 3 p.m. Central Time as the crew members bid their farewells and close the hatches between the vehicles. NASA television also, the undocking coverage will begin at 6:15 p.m. Deorbit and landing coverage will begin at 8:45 p.m. and will continue until the crew is safely in the medical tent at the landing site. Again, landing is scheduled to occur at 10:05 p.m. Central Time.